On this Lord's Day, welcome into the Lord's house as we gather for worship this morning. Pray that the Lord will bless your time here and give you a spiritual lift as well as we hear God's word. If you are our guest or visitor today, we welcome you in the name of Christ. Please sign our guest book and we do invite you to worship with us again. Our order of worship this morning will be the Divine Service, setting number 3. That's on page 184 in the front portion of your hymnal. Our opening hymn is 545, Word of God Come Down on Earth. We will stand on the fourth and final verse. Almighty God, our Maker and Redeemer, we poor sinners confess unto you that we are by nature sinful and unclean, and that we have sinned against you by thought, word, and deed. Wherefore we flee for refuge to your infinite mercy, seeking and imploring your grace for the sake of our Lord Jesus Christ. O most merciful God, who has given your only begotten Son to die for us, have mercy upon us, and for his sake, grant us remission of all our sins, and by your Holy Spirit, increase in us true knowledge of you, and of your will, and true obedience to your word, to the end that by your grace we may come to everlasting life, through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. Almighty God, our Heavenly Father, has had mercy upon us, and has given his only Son to die for us, and for his sake forgives us all our sins. To those who believe on his name, he gives the power to become the children of God, and has promised them his Holy Spirit. He that believes and is baptized shall be saved. Grant this, Lord, unto us all.
Amen.
If you look within your worship folder, you will find there our introit that is printed out for you. This morning from Psalm chapter 67, the congregational tune is the tune from hymn 397. May God be merciful to us and bless us and make his face to shine upon us. Let the whole world know your will, all nations your salvation. Let the nations be glad and sing for joy. Judge the peoples with equity and guide all nations upon earth. The earth has yielded its increase. God, our God, has blessed us. God has blessed us. May all the ends of the earth revere him.
Thank you.
Almighty and everlasting Father, you gave your children many blessings, even though we are undeserving. In every trial and temptation, grant us steadfast confidence in your loving kindness and mercy. Through Jesus Christ, your Son, our Lord, who lives and reigns with you through the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever.
The Old Testament reading for this 11th Sunday after Pentecost is from Isaiah chapter 56, verses 1 and 6 through 8. Thus says the Lord, keep justice and do righteousness, for soon my salvation will come and my deliverance be revealed. And the foreigners who join themselves to the Lord, to minister to him, to love the name of the Lord, and to be his servants, everyone who keeps the Sabbath and does not profane it and holds fast my covenant, I will bring to my holy mountain and make them joyful in my house of prayer. Their burnt offerings and their sacrifices will be accepted on my altar, for my house shall be called a house of prayer for all peoples. The Lord God, who gathers the outcasts of Israel, declares, I will gather yet others to him besides those already gathered. This is the word of the Lord.
Thank you, God. This lesson is found on the back of your worship folder. This morning it is from the book of Romans, chapter 11. The verses are 1 through 2a, 13 to 15, and 28 to 32. We're going to read the words together, and following the reading, we will rise and sing the triple Alleluia on page 190. We read, I ask then, has God rejected his people? By no means, for I myself am an Israelite, a descendant of Abraham, a member of the tribe of Benjamin. God has not rejected his people, whom he foreknew. Now I am speaking to you Gentiles. Inasmuch then as I am an apostle to the Gentiles, I magnify my ministry in order somehow to make my fellow Jews jealous and thus save some of them. For if their rejection means the reconciliation of the world, what will their acceptance mean but life from the dead? As regards the gospel, they are enemies of God for your sake, but as regards election, they are beloved for the sake of their forefathers. For the gifts and the calling of God are irrevocable, just as you were at one time disobedient to God, but now have received mercy because of their disobedience. So they too have now been disobedient, in order that by the mercy shown to you, they also may now receive mercy. For God has consigned all to disobedience, that he may have mercy on all. This is the word of the Lord. Please rise. Holy Gospel according to St. Matthew, the 15th chapter. Will be our sermon text for this morning. Jesus went away from there and withdrew to the district of Tyre and Sidon. And behold, a Canaanite woman from that region came out and was crying, Have mercy on me, O Lord, son of David, my daughter is severely oppressed by a demon. But he did not answer her a word. And his disciples came and begged him, saying, Send her away, for she is crying out after us. He answered, I was sent only to the lost sheep of the house of Israel. But she came and knelt, saying, Lord, help me. And he answered, It is not right to take the children's bread and throw it to the dogs. She said, Yes, Lord. Yet even the dogs eat the crumbs that fall from their master's table. Then Jesus answered her, O woman, great is your faith. Be it done for you as you desire. And her daughter was healed instantly. This is the gospel of the Lord. Different than yours. One thing we probably agree upon, though, is on the care of our child. When they were sick, when they were younger, especially in the middle of the night, you agonized whether to take them to the emergency room or to medicate and care for them at home. Not an easy question, but certainly easier than what the Canaanite woman faces in our text. Her daughter is possessed by a demon. Emergency rooms don't quite have the answers for that. If you have a child that is physically or mentally challenged, you know how you agonize over their care. What should I be doing? Lord, please give me some answers. Where should we be turning when life doesn't work the way you think it should? That's a wall we run into quite frequently, isn't it? When life doesn't work the way you think it should. The facts are these. Change and disappointment and heartache are familiar scenarios. They make up those moments when we find ourselves up against a wall. The Canaanite woman is up against the wall with her daughter. She's desperate for help. She has promptly sought help and not received it, but she does not give up hope. She turns to Jesus for help and hope. She seems to be a God-fearing person by the way she addresses the Savior. Have mercy on me, O Lord, Son of David. But she doesn't expect help, because she's a Canaanite, an ancient enemy of the Israelites. And Jesus has come to this region for rest. The disciples want to turn her away. Jesus responds by testing her faith. He seems a little cool to her request when he says he was only sent for the lost sheep of Israel, and he should not take the children's bread and throw it to the dogs. Dogs is a reference to the non-Jew, who this lady certainly is. Why is Jesus treating her this way? Do you ever feel like the Lord's treating you like a dog? You run here and there and everywhere, chasing your tail until you spin out of control. Like Norm said on Cheers, it's a dog-eat-dog world, and I'm wearing milk-bone underwear. We laugh because it's true. We pursue the things of this world, and that ends up biting us in the backside. Why isn't life working out the way I think it should? Oh, that mother could have had a pity party right there in Tyre and Sidon. But she didn't. She stayed persistent in her humble and confident faith. She seems to understand the point that Jesus is making. She's more than willing to settle for a few crumbs from the Master's table, because she believes it would take just a few crumbs of his power and kindness to make her daughter whole again. Of this situation, it's been said, as Jesus looked on the woman, he did not see her as an interloper, as did the disciples, an unwelcome intruder on his time and energy. Rather, he saw her as a woman of great personal faith, and his conversation with her was designed to test that faith. She passed. Oh, woman, great is your faith. Be it done for you as you desire. And her daughter was healed instantly. The Lord tests our faith when life isn't going the way we think it should. He may be silent for a time. He may be waiting for the right time to respond. He may be strengthening our faith. He wants us to be persistent in faith and prayer and to know his mercy and his help. He often speaks in the midst of silence. the silence of his miracles, the silence before his accusers, his silence on the way to the cross, his silence that was finally broken with, "It is finished." His silence when he came out of the grave. His silence when he forgives and loves and heals. "Have mercy on me, O Lord." Several years ago now, the Billy Graham Evangelism Association sponsored a hymn writing contest, and one of the hymns that never won a prize or made it into any hymnal was entitled, "God's Grip, Don't Slip." Now that's not good grammar at all, but the message is clear. No one can snatch us out of the grip of our loving and powerful Savior. Jesus has rescued us from the grip of Satan through his perfect life, victorious death, and triumphant resurrection. We are safe and secure in his almighty grip now and forever. You see, we live in the confidence. We live in confidence with the assurance that God's grip won't slip. He will never let go of us, even when life doesn't work the way we think it should. Amen.
Please rise for the prayer of the church.
This morning I will conclude each of the prayer petitions with the words, "Let us pray to the Lord." Will you as a congregation please respond, "Lord, have mercy." For the church, that she may steadfastly proclaim the irrevocable gift and calling of God, that the disobedient may receive mercy, and that those who hear may become branches grafted onto the true vine, Jesus Christ. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
For this congregation, that we may bring offerings and sacrifices of praise that are acceptable to God, that we would be a house of prayer for all people, and that through us God would gather in the lost and outcast, the widowed and orphaned, and all who are in need. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
For the government and those who protect us, that they may keep justice and do righteousness, that they may carry out their duty in accord with God's will, and that our land would be blessed with honest industry, truthful education, and an honorable life. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
For the sick and afflicted, for those beset with grief and sorrow, for those in pain or trouble, that the Lord may answer those who beg him according to his will, and have mercy on all. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
We pray for these members of our congregation this week, remembering Dennis and Barb Walker, especially be with Dennis and the pain that he has been having. He continues to get shots to lessen the pain, and he waits for surgery upcoming here. Also, please be with Barb, as she is the helpmate in helping Dennis. Be with Barb in her life as well. Watch over her health. Guide and bless the faith of the Walker family. Be with their children and continue to shower your mercy upon them. And then we pray for Kent and Carrie Warren and their daughter Christina. Please be with Christina in her work. And now that she is out of college and on her own, guide and bless her. Be with Kent and Carrie in their employment. May they have joy in their work and the things that they do. Continue to be with them in their marriage and bless them as a family. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
Into your hands, O Lord, we commend all for whom we pray, trusting in your mercy through Jesus Christ, your Son, our Lord, who lives and reigns with you in the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever. Amen. We join together as we pray. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen. Our worship continues at the bottom of page 201 with the salutation and benedicamus. The Lord be with you. Bless we the Lord. The Lord bless you and keep you. The Lord make his face shine upon you and be gracious unto you. The Lord look upon you with his countenance and give you peace. Good morning and welcome, and the Lord be with you this week as we just continue to hear about what's going to happen tomorrow until it drives us all nuts. But it'll be over after tomorrow, right? Couple of announcements that I have. First of all, the church picnic is next week, so please sign up. You can sign up for what you are bringing and also that your attendance. That again will be at Tipton Trails Park after our second service next week, approximately at 12 noon, somewhere in there. The blood drive is being rescheduled. It will now be Friday, September the 15th from 1 to 5. The theme is going to be a tailgate theme, and we will have different things going on that day. You can sign up back on the table. I've got the sign up out there. Or the easiest way is to just go online to Red Cross Blood or Give Blood, whatever I have in the announcements. Put in our zip code, follow the few prompts, and you can get yourself signed up that way. If you have any questions about the blood drive, please talk to me. And again, that'll be 1 to 5. So those of you that need to get to your high school football games, you can get there. Thank you.
Good morning. I'd like to welcome all guests and visitors. Please introduce yourself to the pastor on your way out. I'd like to draw your attention to one more announcement. Next Sunday, the 27th, we'll have another collection for our new church sign, which will be placed in the south entrance by the trail. Any other announcements anyone would like to bring up? Seeing none, bless the week.